Would the congregation please rise? Welcome in the name of Jesus the Savior, who died and was raised to new life by the grace of God. We are gathered here to worship, to remember before God our sister Meghan, to give thanks for her life, to commend her to our merciful Redeemer, and to comfort one another. When we were baptized in Christ Jesus, the Savior of the world, we were baptized into his death. We are buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, so that as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too may receive new life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. Thanks be to God. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you today our sister Meghan. We thank you for giving her to us to know and to love as a companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see that death has been swallowed up in the victory of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that we may live in confidence and hope until, by your call, we are gathered to our heavenly home in the company of all your saints, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. We'll now hear a beautiful song of reflection that Meghan picked herself, Dancing in the Sky.
Since you left, and here
continue with the reading of God's words. And Brother Ryan and Son Oliver picked out the scripture readings. First, from the New Testament book of Romans, the 14th chapter. If we live, we live to the Lord. And if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, so that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. And our second reading comes from the Gospel of St. Matthew, the 5th chapter. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." And our last reading comes from the Holy Gospel of St. John, the 14th chapter. "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also." Here ends the readings. Kelly and Brenda and Ryan and Leslie and Oliver and Kingston and all of you family, God's comfort be with you this day as you commend back to God a daughter, a sister, a sister-in-law, a mother, all of you family and all of you caregivers for Meghan. God's peace surround you as you trust that God took Meghan to her heavenly home forever. And God bless each one of you as you gather this day, that you remember that you are blessed. You are blessed even when you mourn the loss of a daughter's life, a sister's life, a mother's life, a friend's life. You are blessed as each one of you is a child of God. Meghan was a child of God. From the moment God knit her together in her mother Brenda's womb and then claimed her through her baptism through Memorial Lutheran, right, Kelly? Not Luther Memorial, Memorial Lutheran in Nevada, Iowa, Meghan was blessed. She was blessed with God's love given to her in Jesus Christ, who died on the cross, who was raised to new life so that he could go and prepare a place for Meghan, for all believers to be able to dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Meghan was blessed. And not only for her eternal life that is now hers in heaven, but she was also blessed to receive God's mercy and love as she was carried by God's grace here in her 39 years here in this lifetime of living with you. Even though I've known Meghan now for several years, I never knew until you showed me the other day and told me the other day, family, that Meghan showed and rode American Saddlebred horses. So when Brenda got home, she texted me a picture of Meghan, and you could see her sitting on the horse with a huge, beautiful smile, with her breeches, which I learned are the pants that they wear, the gloves, the beautiful coat and the hat. Meghan sat right on that saddlebred horse with such poise and such faith. Faith that they would be carried through on that course they were to ride. Meghan would be carried forth with ease and grace. In these past years, especially after Meghan knew that her life would be shortened due to the brain cancer, later the pulmonary disease, Meghan sat herself up, much like she used to in that saddle of her horse, with poise and faith. Faith that she would be carried forth in grace. Being carried by grace was the only way that Meghan was called blessed. After the last few years, after Meghan found out everything after the first brain surgery, Meghan came to visit me a few times in person, several times over Zoom. She wanted to talk about faith and about God. She wanted to ask a lot of questions. She knew that through the grace of God, she was saved. But she asked me that. Can it really be that easy? She said, isn't there something more I'm supposed to do? I just simply replied to her, no, Meghan, there's not anything else you have to do. Jesus did it all for you. It's all about God's grace that carries you through this lifetime and to the next. I truly believe that because Meghan asked such faithful, curious questions, she knew. She absolutely knew. She was forgiven for any struggle she had in her past, and she knew she was freed. Freed from any worry of her own salvation. And Brenda, I am pretty sure that because she knew, that's why she could worry about you needing to get the butter dish out that you didn't think you needed. And that's why I know, Ryan, that she knew you were all taken care of, that she could still worry about you as a sibling, even from those younger days when you would battle in the car and maybe Dad dropped you off, but thank God someone else picked you up too. That is why that she could worry about all of you, dear family and friends, that you got the best bargain shopping, that you could visit Pioneer Village together, and that you both boys, Oliver and Kingston, you could do a special trip. Oh, I remember when we visited on Zoom that day. You boys didn't know yet, but she was so excited to be ready to get to tell you that you were going to go to Kansas City, to Legoland, Great Wolf Lodge. And I'm pretty sure there was part of her that knew it, too, that after she went to confirmation camp in her junior high days, she came back and she sang those camp songs, especially when she knew it annoyed her teachers at school. We know these things that Meghan knew, that she was carried by grace and need not worry about herself. But we also know there are some things we cannot know. Not even this day. Things for which we do not have an answer. We do not have an answer for why Meghan could not be saved from the pulmonary disease, from cancer. We don't have an answer. I so wish we did, Oliver and Kingston, of why you have to say goodbye to your mom too soon. We don't have an answer why parents have to bury a daughter, a brother, a sister. But what we do know is this. We know that Meghan was and still is the Lord's. As the scripture so beautifully says, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. We know that by the power of the resurrection of Jesus Christ our Lord, Meghan was raised to new life in her new resurrected body, where there's no more cancer, no more pain, no more pulmonary disease. Now, Oliver, one of our church souls shared with me what you knew. Little did you know, for getting ready for confirmation, you'd be quoted later. Right before Oliver was confirmed last fall, they all shared faith boards. Kind of looks like a science fair, but it's their writing about their faith, pictures of significant things as they believe in God. This one soul asked Oliver this question: what is one takeaway from your faith journey so far? Oliver, how beautiful what you said. The comfort of knowing that my mom will be with Jesus. Oliver in Kingston, the number one thing that your mom kept sharing with me in all those visits was that she wanted you to always know, that you will be carried by the same grace that carried her all her days, to know that your mom is with Jesus. She is now where, as she got to see glimpses in these past years that were so beautiful, she described it as the most beautiful and vivid colors where they are, where the most beautiful, luxurious, bountiful flowers are. She is with Jesus, and Jesus is with you. Dear ones, do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe in Jesus, who is with you this day and all your days to come until you are reunited with Meghan again. And all of God's people say, amen. We'll sing together, everyone, another hymn that Meghan picked for us. In the Garden, it's on the back of your bulletin. We continue in our bulletin, everyone, as you see the Apostles' Creed. Please rise as you are able as we proclaim the same faith and grace which carried Meghan, the same grace and faith that carries you. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray to our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am the resurrection and the life. Jesus, fullness of compassion, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to all who mourn for Meghan, especially her dear family and friends, and dry their tears as they weep. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Jesus, firstborn of the new creation, you raised the dead. Give to our sister Meghan life eternal. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Jesus, wellspring of life, you washed our sister Meghan in baptism and anointed her with the Holy Spirit. Give her communion with all your saints. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Jesus, bread of life, you nourished Meghan at your table on earth. Welcome her at your table in the realm of heaven. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of all grace, we give you thanks because by his death our Savior Jesus Christ destroyed the power of death and by his resurrection opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Make us certain that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life nor things present nor things to come shall be able to separate us from your love, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not in temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let us commend Meghan to the mercy of God, our Maker and our Redeemer. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your child, Meghan. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. Let us go forth in peace, in the name of Christ. Amen. Just a word of invitation on behalf of the family, everyone. We will be eating lunch together right after the service, so please join us right here in the fellowship hall. We sing together our recessional hymn, Amazing Grace.
Thank you. I drive a sports car just to prove I'm a real big baller, cause I made $1 million and I spend it on girls and shoes. But you don't wanna be high like me, never really know why like me. You don't ever wanna step off that roller coaster and be all alone. And you don't wanna ride the bus like this, never know who to trust like this. You don't wanna be stuck up on that stage singing, stuck up on that stage singing. Oh, I know sad souls, sad souls. Darling, all I know are sad souls, sad souls. Of a pop song people forgot. And I can't keep a girl, no, cause as soon as the sun comes up I cut them all loose and work's my excuse. But the truth is I can't open up. And you don't wanna be high like me, never really know why like me. You don't ever wanna step off that roller coaster and be all alone. And you don't wanna ride the bus like this, never know who to trust like this. You don't wanna be stuck up on that stage and stuck up on that stage singing. Oh, I know sad souls, sad souls. Darling, all I know are sad souls, sad souls.